Fawns will bleat. So they make a little blah sound. And basically it's saying, Mom, where are you? Mule deer are an iconic species in the western United States, and populations have been declining for the last 30 or 40 years. Our study site is in south central Utah on Monroe Mountain, and we are studying the effects of predators on fawn survival. And to do that, we usually capture the adult females in March. We will do a bunch of measurements. We have an ultrasound machine that we quickly determine whether she's pregnant or not. And if she's pregnant, then she becomes one of our study animals. We put a radio collar on them so that we can follow them and locate the birth site when they give birth, and we'll release her back onto the winter range.
We got two.
Where are you?
We want to know, one, what the survival rate of fawns is, and two, what the cause-specific mortality is.
We have this mountain area split up into two study sections, and so we're calling fawns in both areas to see what kind of effect predators have on fawn survival.
We find fawns two different ways. Some females are collars and have implant transmitters in them. When they give birth, the transmitter falls out and activates. We go and listen each morning to each of the deer's collars.
Whichever direction that the beep is the loudest is the direction deer is in. He's over in those hills, those far hills over there.
We can go to the birth site and search within 100 yards or so and locate the fawns normally. So that's one method that we've used. The other is we will just find a good vantage point that looks over a lot of open country. Just watch for females.
And you may be 1 or 2 miles away looking through a spotting scope.
Our hope is that they'll go to their fawns. Their fawns will stand up and feed, lay back down, and we can go collar their fawns.
The whole field crew, they're in tip-top shape. They're machines. They can run up the mountain. They can run down the mountain. They may run 1 or 2 miles. They may climb 2,000 feet of elevation. They can get there. You really have to look carefully every square foot of the whole area you're searching to see if you can find them. They'll lay their head down, lay their ears flat, and remain completely motionless. And so if they're under the vegetation, they're very hard to see. Once we find the birth site, we'll do a systematic search. We typically find 1 or 2 fawns. We try to limit our handling time to 1 or 2 minutes. We'll take several quick measurements, we'll weigh the animal, and then we'll put a collar that just slips over its head, and it's an elastic collar that expands as the animal grows.
Oh, that is a big fawn. 4.78 kilograms.
It's super exciting to walk up and see a small 4 or 5 pound fawn, see it laying there and pick it up and it just remains still in your hand. That's the best part of it.
They're very cute animals. They're small and they don't move a lot when they're young.
Between last year and this year, we've captured about 130 fawns. The females will come right back and we haven't had any problems with abandonment. To wisely manage any natural resource, we have to understand factors that are influencing that natural resource. Once we know those factors, then we can effectively manage the population.